I understand that I have a very difficult task lying ahead of me because I have 5 minutes to describe what happened in the last couple of months. And in addition to that, I have to be politically correct, because I cannot criticize too much, obviously, being an ambassador of the Ukraine in one of the countries of the European Union. When it comes, ladies and gentlemen, to the position of the European Union and of the US and the rest of the world and the reaction to the events on Crimea, Ukraine, I wanted to make two remarks. First of all, the first reaction of the Western world in the context of the aggression of Russia on Crimea. This was the first reaction, first topic, and second topic or second reaction started when this aggression started to develop in the eastern part of the Ukraine. And in reality, for all of us, that what had happened on Crimea was a shock. I can tell it only from my perspective. It was a shock for me. It was a huge shock, because we could not imagine in the 21st century a neighboring country can military way react to changes of government in the Ukraine. But this shock was not only a shock for the Ukraine, but I think that this was also a shock for the European Union and even to some extent the US. The US were maybe more active or better informed, but still no one was ready to give Ukraine this solution, how to react. And this change of approach and attitude of the US and the EU when it comes to introducing sanctions due to Russian aggression happened when it became completely clear for political leaders of those countries that Russia is or made the decision to make a step forward, to go further, and we do not know where Russia might stop. So we had to react. I hope that this change in awareness of the leaders of the European Union and the US and their new approach that you actually should take the initiative and you should impose sanctions on a political and diplomatic level in order not only to stop Russia so that no any further action happens, but that it also retreats from the territory, from Crimea and from the Ukraine, because we are starting to get used to the situation that Crimea is a part of Russia, that it was annexed by Russia, and no one talks about this anymore. It's like a fact for many people, and I think that for the Western world it should be important that those sanctions should be extended, should, because the US, because the Russia broke the international law and the laws of good neighbor policy. If we will accept that, then this would mean that we will still be under pressure of what Russia might do, that Russia can do whatever they want to and they cannot be stopped. I expect, however, we are of course in the Ukraine for this. We want this conflict to be solved in a peaceful way. But unfortunately, I suppose that this cannot be done only during discussions and dialogue, and which is why I think that all options should be open. Also, when it comes to supporting the Ukraine with weapons and additional military forces, but also trying to put pressure on Russia, thanks to sanctions or bilateral talks with the leadership. Naturally, we would like this to happen as soon as possible, especially when it comes to the retreat of the Russian troops from the Ukraine and a ceasefire. But we have to count on ourselves, and we are perfectly aware of the fact that this is not only a problem of the Ukraine, this should be a matter of all of those who are for democracy, freedom, and a peaceful coexistence of countries in Europe. And without joint actions, this will not be possible. Thank you very much.